Hi, my name is Maximiliano Firtman. I'm a web developer and also a mobile app developer. I have created this course so you can take your current web skills and create an offline-capable app that is installable on mobile and desktop operating systems. We are going to start with a web app that is not a PWA. So after understanding what a PWA is, we are going to add some layers, such as the web app manifest for installation, service worker for offline usage, and we're going to see how you can distribute your app, not just in the browser, but also in app stores. I hope you enjoy the course. So I'm here with Google Chrome for desktop, and I'm on a Mac, but it can be also a Linux, a Chromebook device, or a Windows device from Windows 7. Okay, so I just need to go to a URL that has a PWA inside. Many apps. It can be a Starbucks. It can be for example, Amazon Luna or Google Stadia for cloud gaming. They are PWAs. But I will try YouTube Music. It's music.youtube.com. It's a PWA. And how do I know it's a PWA? Well, actually, after a while, if you look at the URL bar, you're going to see a new icon that will appear. Actually, the browser is making some tests, and we're going to talk about that in a minute. If the test passes, you will see this icon that says Install YouTube Music. And also, in the menu, you will find Install YouTube Music. If at this point you're asking, hey, who is going to know that? Well, give me a second, because I will show you another example that looks better. If I click on Install YouTube Music, I have a nice native dialogue saying, do you want to install the app, YouTube Music? And I can click Install, and it will actually install my app. Before actually doing that, let me show you another example that if you're a web designer or a web developer, you will probably like this PWA. It's called Squoosh. It's squoosh.app. It's actually an image compressor. So you can actually drop a PNG, even an animated GIF, and it can compress that and convert that into a different format or a more compressed PNG or a WebP file. If you look at it within the UI at the top right, we have an install button. This is actually not a native button. It's HTML. I just want to show you this is just a button, okay, an HTML button. Well, actually, so within the user interface of your PWA, you can have a button. And if I click there, it actually triggers that native dialog. And if I now install Squoosh, and also I can install YouTube Music, what will happen is now we're going to have apps, standalone apps from YouTube Music and Squoosh, and they have their own window. They appear in the Alt tab or Command tab, YouTube Music, Squoosh. They appear in the search. I mean, if I search for Squoosh, I have the app. In Windows, they appear in the Start menu as any other app. And now it has its own window, and you can see that the window, it's actually separated from Google Chrome, from the browser. And that's kind of the idea of how the PWA installation looks like on desktop. So something that we need to do is to use that service worker to cache and serve the resources of our PWA. So the service worker has a local cache. In fact, to be technically accurate, the cache is also available outside of the service worker. It's called the Cache Storage API. With that storage, we can save all the resources that we need or just a few. We decide. Everything is heavily based in JavaScript promises. So please have in mind that we're going to see a lot of async await or a lot of then when we're using this API. Most of the common scenarios include the ability to prefetch on installation. That means when you install a service worker, what will happen is that you're going to prefetch, so you're going to download assets that you will need later. Also, you can do cache on request. So instead of pre-caching, you can cache on request. So when you are actually getting into a section of the PWA and you are downloading for the first time the assets, you cache those assets at that point. So this is a big advantage over classic native app development, because that means that you decide here the algorithm that you want to use in terms of the resources, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, JSON, videos, anything that you need for your PWA. Most of the time, we follow an app shell pattern. That means that we download at least all the files that are necessary to render the app shell. So the app shell is everything that you see in the user interface. Maybe there is a section that is not actually downloaded, but at least we have the basics to actually render an error message in case that's what we want. After we cache the resources, we need to serve them, because remember, we are going to be a server. So in this case, the service worker will respond for every request that the PWA make. It can make a decision, serve from the cache, forward the request to the network, or it can even synthesize a response. That means create a response on the fly, as if we were Apache with PHP, okay, if you want. So, but in this case, it's JavaScript, and it's executed client-side. Any mixed algorithm is possible here. So you are in charge. And that's an advantage, but also responsibilities that we have that we didn't have before. So a warning here, the service worker API, it's a low-level API. So that means that we have a lot of power, but also a lot of, we need to put a lot of work for some basic behavior. So the question is that, can we have a PWA that doesn't actually need a real server because the service worker can actually answer for all those requests? So in theory, yes. The problem is who is serving the service worker the first time. So you actually need a server to serve the service worker and the HTML that registers the service worker. And then probably the service worker will need some place to download the resources the first time. But after everything was registered and installed, then in theory, you could potentially like shut down your real server. However, that's the theory. In practice, because the service worker is a middleware, you should always think that something will happen that will probably remove the data. It can be the user going to settings and deleting everything. It can be the user buying a new device. You go and buy a new device, a new laptop, a new phone. Yeah, maybe you have the icon again because you are recovering the backup, but you don't have the assets. So that's why we are not going to stop using the server. So the server is always there. We are using the service worker as a middleware to help performance and offline abilities. But we are still missing one piece. If I add some node here, and then I refresh, I'm losing that content. And to be offline, we actually need to save the data. That's simple. That has nothing to do with the PWA platform. That's just the web. You can use IndexedDB or local storage to save the data. In my case, I will just use local storage. It's actually pretty simple. I'm going to app.js. And first, every time we need to save the data, that is, for example, here, this is when we are pushing a new node, we can call save. And also when we are deleting, we can call save as well. That save function does not exist, so we need to actually create that one. Function save, we're going to take local storage, we're going to set an item, this will create a new entry, with one particular key, we can call this notes, and we can only store a string, so we need to stringify our array of notes into JSON format, so actually it's going to be a string. This is how we save. And then when the page loads in our DOM content loaded event, before rendering the node, I can check if I have some saved notes, and then I will retrieve them. So that's easy as well. I will check if in the local storage we have something for the item notes. And if we do, we're going to save in our collection JSON parse of local storage get item notes. So now let's go back to Chrome and see if it now works completely offline. We can refresh or reload, right-click reload, to get the latest version. And let's see if it's saving. If I click and reload, you can see it's not. And you say, what's going on? Well, I'm not using DevTools here. So, which means the reload system that reloads the service worker, it's not actually working. And I didn't change the service worker file. So now that I have installed a version, I always have the old version. So I always have the old version of app.js. That's my problem. So how can I actually do this? How can I force an update? Well, we can see that cache first has some limitations. So we have a problem. It's like we need to update this app.js. Let me show you the same with another example. We can change one color. For example, instead of the title back, we can change this to red. Okay, so I'm changing that color to red. And I'm coming here, right-click, reload. It's not red. Right-click, reload. It's not red. Why? Because I'm using the cached version always. So we have a problem. Can I shift reload? Well, not actually from the PWA. If I'm in the browser, I can do shift reload. In fact, let's do that. Let's close the PWA and open this in the browser. I can close that, or I can use the menu, open in Chrome. And now we are back into Chrome. Again, I refresh, nothing happens. I shift refresh, and I see red. Because now I'm bypassing the service worker, and I'm going directly to the server. But if I go back and refresh normally, I'm back in the old version. So we have a problem, okay? So with shift reload, this will probably save the data. Shift reload, it works. I'm shift reloading, I still have the data. But if I reload normally, I don't have the data. So it's like we have two versions of the app running at the same time. So that's because cache first, it's actually limited. And we need another way to update the app. One simple way that you have is that you can go to a service worker, okay, and then change something, such as one space. It doesn't make any sense. And more than changing a space, you can change a character, such as a version number. So every time there is a change in one byte, because the browser is doing a byte-by-byte comparison in the service worker, it will trigger an update. The problem is that the update will actually install the assets again. Okay, so let's see. I'm coming here, I'm going to reload. I'm still in the old version. But if I reload again without shift, normal reload, I'm getting the new version. And now I will always have the new version. Let's do that again. If we don't like that red and we want to go back to the previous color, we go back, we save the file, and we also go and change the version of a service worker or a timestamp or any character. So now, if I go back to Chrome, I reload twice and I'm getting the new version. Okay? So this is one solution to the update problem. If every time you make a change in one asset, you go and update something in the service worker, it can be a comment, then the user will actually get the whole package again. That's one way. And now everything works offline, even deleting the data, or saving new nodes.